Okay, so here at the end of the year, I wanted to add my own top 10 games of the decade list to your already immense list of lists that are on the internet, so you can have another video to watch that you don't really care about. These are my top 10 games of the decade. They are not necessarily the most critically acclaimed games or necessarily the best sellers, but it's my list, so... Number 10, Pokemon Go. I actually had a script that I started to write for this, and then I decided I'm just gonna ad-lib it because I'm an amateur. But I do want to read you this first paragraph from my explanation of why I chose Pokemon Go as game number 10 of Jake Terrio's Games of the Decade. We have never been closer to knowing world peace than during the first weeks of Pokemon Go's launch. Launched the same month that Donald Trump would be nominated as the Republican candidate for president, the dichotomy between the camaraderie fostered by Pokemon Go and the looming US presidential election could not have been more stark. Game number 9, GTA Online. So GTA Online is one of those games that is an absolute nightmare, like almost like a manifestation of the seventh circle of hell if you're playing by yourself. But playing GTA Online with your friends is just about the most fun you can have online, I think, in any multiplayer game. Game number 8 is Red Hook's Darkest Dungeon. The art style, the gameplay, the vocal performance from Wayne June, the writing, it's amazing. And it's just this incredibly engrossing, turn-based, dungeon-crawly thing. And you should play it, because it's phenomenal. Dark's Dungeon is amazing, you should go play it. Game number 7, Portal 2. This was one that I included not so much because I super enjoyed it, which I did, but because it came out early in the decade, and I think it had a profound effect on puzzle games that came after it. And I think kind of finessed and fine-tuned that Portal formula to a game that is really exceptional. They added the voice talent of J.K. Simmons, who at the time did not have an Academy Award, but now has an Academy Award, so they can say Academy Award winner J.K. Simmons is a voice in Portal 2. Let's move on. Number 6, Torchlight 2. I had played Diablo, I had played games like Torchlight before, but something about Torchlight just kinda clicked for me. So then when the sequel came out, it had like an overworld and it had local multiplayer, so my brother and I were able to play it together, and it was just all of the things I liked about Torchlight enhanced. Lost tons of hours into it. Game number 5 is Fez. Fez is on here for several reasons. One, dovetailing off the discussion of Portal 2. Portal 2 was when I was like, oh, puzzle games. All right, that's kind of cool. So then I got to Fez. I think I finished Fez in 2 or 3 sittings because it was so captivating. But the real reason Fez is on this list is because it was the game that introduced me to Disaster Piece. And that introduction was something of a revelation for me, personally, for reasons we'll get to later. Moving on. Number 4, Pony Island by Dan Mullins. Pony Island is incredible, and I'm actually not gonna say a lot about it for the sake of spoiling the experience. I saw the trailer, I bought the game, I invited a buddy over, and we recorded a let's play of it. We played that game in one sitting. It's not incredibly long, but it is a profoundly shocking, I don't even wanna say shocking, because that's not quite the right word. It's just such a unique game. Visually, gameplay-wise, there was stuff where like you have to like move words around on the game's menus to get it to do stuff. Just things, unexpected, that's the word I wanna use. There's a couple of things that it does throughout that were legitimately, this is where I'll use shocking, that were legitimately shocking, that kind of recontextualize what I thought a video game could be. Game number 3, Destiny 2. I wanna kind of consider this the Destiny franchise holistically, but because Bungie has published 2 separate games, I'm gonna say Destiny 2 more so than Destiny 1, because I put more hours into Destiny 2. I think I've enjoyed Destiny 2 more content-wise than some of the stuff in Destiny 1, because it's got more of that finesse, more of that polish, jumping off what Bungie started with Destiny, building on it in Destiny 2. I love sci-fi, I love a well-crafted first-person shooter. I think that you could argue that Destiny has the best gunplay of any FPS on the market right now. It has become something truly special, and I'm very interested to see where it goes in the next decade. And I'm frightened for when I'm gonna get that email from PlayStation that tells me how many hours of it I've played this year. Game number two on my list is another game that I've already done a video for on this channel, and that is Frictional's Soma. Soma came out 4 years ago, 2015, in the fall. I think it was September of 2015, and I played it very soon after release, and I played it in two sittings alone in my parents' apartment, and it has stuck with me since then in a way that very few other games have. It's a survival horror, kind of. The horror elements are less monster things chasing you, though there are sequences where that happen, and more existential questions that are asked in such a way that you, the player, come away from it going, oh, what does that mean for me? I can't speak highly enough of Soma. If you have not played it, you should play it. It's number two on my list of games of the decade, so that should mean something, because obviously my opinion means something to you, the person who's clicked on this video. Game number one, game of the decade, arguably of the century, Hyper Light Drifter by Heart Machine, Alex Preston and Company. Story time, a little bit, to lead into this. So, I discovered Hyper Light Drifter while playing Fez. I am the kind of person who, when I find something I enjoy, I will go Google it to find supplementary information about it. So I played Fez. I was like, the soundtrack's really good. Who wrote the soundtrack? Disaster Beast wrote the soundtrack. Go to Bandcamp. Buy the album on Bandcamp. Go to Disaster Beast's website. Go to upcoming projects. See a trailer for Hyper Light Drifter. Watch trailer for Hyper Light Drifter and go, what is this? So the Kickstarter had already happened. They'd already earned $600,000+ on Kickstarter. And then I was watching the trailer 3 or 4 months before the game was supposed to come out. I buy the game. I think I beat it in 18 or 19 hours. A lot of that was repeating boss fights over and over, playing a boss until very late in the night, go to bed, wake up, beat it first try, because that's how those things go for some reason. I've since played through Hyper Light Drifter 6 times. I own the game on 3 consoles. I bought it for myself on Steam, bought it for my brother on Steam, bought it for a friend on Steam, bought it digital on PS4, bought it physical on PS4, bought it digital on Switch. If that gives you any indication of how much I enjoyed this game. I bought the soundtrack digital, I bought the soundtrack on cassette, I bought the soundtrack on vinyl. People are like, why did you buy a digital soundtrack on an analog format? Shut up, it's great. I can't say enough about Hyper Light Drifter. It was an experience for me that was so obviously personal to the creators that the impact it has when you're playing it cannot be understated. Much like Soma, I have too many nice things to say about Hyper Light Drifter to really condense them into like one nugget of why you should play it. But yeah, it's phenomenal. So those are my games of the decade. If you are watching this and have not played any of them, maybe go play them. Jake Terrio's top 10 games of the decade.
Hey everybody, this is Jake Terrio with Subpixel. If you've made it this far, hopefully it means you enjoyed that video that you just watched. So if you could leave a like and a comment and subscribe if you're not subscribed already, that lets us and our robot overlords at YouTube know that this video is worth watching. So thank you for that, and we'll see you next time.